The digitalization of plants has been one of the focus topics in process automation for years. The first obstacle that needs to be overcome is the data acquisition directly in the field. For this purpose, the NAMUR organization has developed the NAMUR Open Architecture, or for short, NOA. We would like to present the NOA concept and our Beckhoff solution in the next few slides. A typical automation architecture looks like this. So here we have the automation pyramid with the different layers. And the typical NOA use case would be to retrieve all the information, all the data from the field level, so directly from the process, and make this information available to higher level systems. Currently, not all information are read from the field, so a lot of data is already lost on this first step. A big requirement for NOA is that it needs to be compatible for both brownfield and greenfield applications, and of course it may not impact existing automation systems. So the NOA came up with the concept of a second channel. So here we have the NOA side channel, which spreads across all the different layers of the automation pyramid, therefore enabling the communication down from the field level all the way up to all other systems that we have in the automation architecture. As it bypasses all the other layers, it actually is independent from them and therefore does not affect existing automation systems. So if we take a look at an example, like over here we have a smart field device, which can be a temperature sensor, for example, that provides a lot of data already. And typically only the process value, so in this case the temperature, is read from the device and then used by the DCS system for the process control. But there's a lot of other functionality or a lot of other information that the device typically provides, for example, for the condition of the device itself, or maybe some information on the process quality or similar information. And yeah, those kind of information is already lost on this first step. So now we bring in the NOA Edge device, which will read all the additional information, convert the data, and map them to the NOA information model and make the data available to higher level systems through an OPC UA server. So if you take a look at the NOA architecture, we see that all the existing infrastructure, so the existing DCS system, the controllers and so on, will remain untouched. And we simply add the NOA Edge device, which is represented by those blue blocks over here. So here we have the second channel that connects to the field device. And also, we can grab some data from the existing PLC, so from the existing controller. And all of that information is made available through the OPC UA server. The OPC UA server then publishes the data for device management or optimization functionality. So yeah, higher level systems can then run some analytics either locally on the plant itself, or also in a central MNO system, which aggregates the data from different locations of the same operator, for example. If we take a look at the devices that are in that system, we see the existing DCS system. So that typically connects to the field devices. For example, the vast majority of process instrumentation uses the HART protocol. Oftentimes, only the 4 to 20 milliamp signal is being read from the DCS system, and all additional information that is inside those smart devices is lost. But now with the Edge device, we can actually connect to the HART interface of devices and read all further information from there. So basically, the Edge device establishes the HART communication, will read the data, convert that if necessary, and map it to the NOA information model so that the data becomes available through the OPC UA server. On top of that, we can also install some further sensors, for example, for vibration monitoring or similar functionality, which will then also be integrated either into the same OPC UA server or into a separate Edge device that will publish the data for the higher level systems as well. In the next two steps, I would like to explain how the NOA Edge device itself works. So for Beckhoff, we use a standard embedded PC, which is a standard PLC controller with some attached HART terminals. But in theory, it would also work with other protocols. So we could also just add some other I/O terminals for other protocols as well. But typically, in our first applications, we use HART for the communication to the devices. So first of all, it's important to understand that the challenge for the HART devices is that every single device is different from another HART device. So the interface is very device specific. So the first step that we need to do is we need to kind of identify what device is connected. Therefore, we just scan the connected devices and we read out an ID which represents the field device. Then we have a field device repository on the NOAA Edge device, which contains all the different field devices that are known to the system. And we just search this repository for the IDs of the connected field devices. Inside the repository, we have all the data that is required to establish the hard communication to the devices. So basically, we will read what kind of hard commands we need to send to read the information from the device. And yeah, after we have established the hard communication, we will just cyclically read all the parameters that are relevant from the device. Afterwards, this information is mapped to the NOAA information model. So therefore, we convert some of the values to the right data format, for example, map it to the NOAA information model. And then this kind of information is just made available through the OPC UA server to higher level systems. So here we have a standardized interface that all higher level systems that support the NOAA concept can just simply access automatically. When we want to take a look at an example over here where we have a pH meter, so a pH sensor, and on the higher level we see there is some general information that is valid for every device type, so something like manufacturer or model that just exists for every device. And then below that we find the device type specific information, for example here for the pH meter. There's some information about the device itself, so maybe there's some condition monitoring that could be used based on this information. And so with the NOAA information model, every pH meter will look exactly like this. So we from Beckhoff have a very efficient, very flexible solution for the NOAA concept. And we have a plug-and-play solution which automatically detects all connected devices and will just establish the communication based on the field device repository. We also have a very scalable solution because we can just add to the modular I/O system. So we can just add some more hard terminals, for example, to add more channels and more devices to the system. The field device repository is also in a separate file, so we can just update that file and add some new devices to the system. For example, if we have a new pH meter that we didn't have beforehand, we can just add that in the new database, and then it can also be read and used for the NOAA communication. The hardware itself is very compact, so it can also be installed in the brownfield, for example, where we have very limited space inside a cabinet. We can also, during operation, change the connected devices. So if we disconnect a certain device from a channel and connect a different device, that will be automatically detected, and the program code will just adapt to that. And of course, we can also use that embedded PC that we have for some other functionality on top of the NOAA functionality. So we can also integrate some other automation functionality into the same hardware, which again makes the solution even more compact. The NAMUR Open Architecture will play a central role in the digitalization of process plants in the future. We from Beckhoff provide a very flexible and very efficient solutions for that. If you are interested in our solution, do not hesitate to contact us and discuss your plans for digitalization in the future.